Good afternoon, oil traders. It is 3:38 p.m. here on October 17th, Tuesday, ahead of all the news that is coming tonight and tomorrow. And it was quite a ride, as you can see from the chart. We dropped from a high of 52.19, which is frustrating for me because it's kind of where I would have liked to get in had I not bought yesterday. But as you can tell, I did get an opportunity to get out as we did dive. Fortunately, this time I acted quickly and I did sell. I missed the very bottom, but got out not too far off the bottom at 51.30. I sold the entire position that I bought yesterday, anticipating a bounce, which is exactly what happened. I decided not to sell at Europe's close, where we basically were holding at about 51.50, 51.45, that kind of ballpark area. And I decided to wait a little bit longer, and when we dove to 51.30, that seemed good enough for me because of the way the resistance level appeared. It looked like a place where we could bounce. It was hard to tell whether we were going to make an attempt for 51 even, or below, of course, or to bounce. And I decided to hedge my bets and play the bounce card, which is what happened. So as we climbed back up, I tried to be as patient as I possibly could, and ultimately bought in at 51.63, which is kind of this area where we hesitated earlier that day. But I bought in at half the position size that I had yesterday. So here you can see the position that I repurchased has a weighting of, this is the results. So this is the 19-hour hold from today's sale of yesterday's buy, which returned just over 2% and about $345. As you can see from the portfolio, I repurchased very light with only a 10% weighting, which is currently, of course, down because we continue to climb higher. As we touched 52 again, we actually touched 52.01. It was tempting to add to my position considering that I did buy so light today, but I decided that it would be a little bit too aggressive considering my heavy exposure to the downside. You know, obviously crude has a willingness to climb to and possibly above $52. So I'm willing to wait until tomorrow's session and see if I can purchase better, higher above $52. And if that opportunity does present itself tomorrow ahead of EIA news following tonight's API announcement, then I will do that, just that. But as of right now, I think I'm just going to hang on to my liquid cash for the evening session and just wait and see. The position that I have at 51.63 right now is small and it's well situated, so yeah, I'm not too hurried to add to the position just yet. We'll see how we open tomorrow. But yeah, I at least managed to call the opportunity right, and I'll have the opportunity to act again tomorrow if that continues to go in my favor. But for the time being, I'm happy with how I played it. Of course, I could have done better. That's almost always the case. But yeah, for now, it's good enough. How'd you guys do? Let me know in the comments down below on YouTube or over on TradingJournal.ca, where you can find more information on my portfolio, trades, results, etc., etc. In the meantime, give us a thumbs up, subscribe to stay tuned, and I'll check back with you guys following tonight's API announcement at 4:30 and ahead of trading tomorrow at 9:30 a.m. Eastern Time. Till then, good luck. Cheers.